Libyan rebels have kidnapped the country's Prime Minister Ali Zidane and taken him to an undisclosed location. Now, for more on the story, we're joined on the line by Naheem Jenna from the Afro Middle East Center. Naheem, good morning to you.
Good morning.
Now, there's been conflicting reports about who kidnapped the Libyan Prime Minister. Which group is likely to commit this act?
Well, it seems clear now that that there were two groups that were involved in the kidnapping. Both groups actually in some way linked to the government and playing some kind of anti-crime role. Both previously rebel militias, but now linked to the government. So the one, for example, is the Committee for Fighting Crime, as it's called. So linked to the government in some kind of way, but obviously they've been unhappy about the Prime Minister and kidnapping.
Why are they unhappy with the Prime Minister?
Well, you know, apart from the general kind of instability in the country, I think this particularly is a response to what has happened over the past few days, literally. The one incident, of course, was a few days ago when American forces came in and kidnapped from Libya Anas al-Libi for various activities that they're accusing him of, being a member of Al-Qaeda, etc., and took him out of the country. The Libyan government responded saying that they were unhappy about this, but there's some sense that that in fact they had given tacit approval for the operation to take place. And what adds to that notion is that on Monday, the Prime Minister Ali Zidane gave an interview to BBC where he said that that Libya was awash with weapons, that it was a base for exporting weapons through other countries in the region, and he called on Western countries to assist Libya in ending the militancy there. Last month, he also visited Britain, and he appealed for British help to get rid of weapons from Libya. And so these seem to be the main reasons why there's been unhappiness about him, his kind of invitation, if you like, to Western countries to come into Libya in security operations.
To what extent will the kidnapping affect the fragile Libyan government?
It could have a serious effect. At the moment, the center, in terms of the central government, is not very strong. It's facing, rebellion or obstacles from the east, from other parts of the country. It's having to deal with all of these militias. The security situation is very bad. In the east, in the Benghazi area, the production of oil has been considerably decreased because the view there is that they're not going to allow the oil production to continue until they get more of a share out of the oil for the east. So you have that kind of a rebellion going on in the country. This action now will further weaken the central government, and with the central government weakening even further, the role of militias, for example, will become even stronger, and your security situation will get worse. Greater possibility of the east, for example, or the south breaking away from the center. So, potentially, unless it's dealt with very quickly and effectively, potentially this could have serious repercussions.
Now, Ingina from the Afro Middle East Center, thank you so much for your time.
Thank you.